welcome to another NOLA Wargaming Battle Report. So this battle is a little different than the other battles you've seen on here in the past, mainly because there are six people involved and 16,000 points on each side. Yes, each side. So 32,000 points total sitting on these tables, or 30,000 to 32, whatever. Anyway, we didn't overly plan this, so it's not like we had everything perfectly balanced and lists submitted beforehand or anything like that. We told everyone to show up with what they wanted to use, and this is how it ended up. It's me and Midnight Fox on one side of the table, and on the other side we have Turkey Sub, Bone 67, Lil Ed, and Skittles. So that's all of us. Not a lot of special rules. We just told everyone to put their stuff down, and at the end of the probably somewhere around 4 or 5 turns, these things take a very long time, we would just look at the table and decide who won that way. Like I said, pretty informal. Anyway, let's move on to the start. So we decided that most people were just going to set their armies up and really in front of them. That way people wouldn't have to walk around all these tables. It's a lot of stuff, so if people have to constantly walk past each other, it gets to be a problem. It slows down the games. So for the most part, people have what they have right in front of them. There's a couple of exceptions to that, as you see, like, the skeleton chariots belong to, that's got to be Bone 67s. On the right side, you'll see some winged reapers and skeletal archers. Those belong to Lil Ed. But everything from Turkey Sub is right here on the table. It's a mainly Kingdom Knights-based army. He's got some grails, but it really just took a whole bunch of the knights. Just kind of plopped them down. And, you know, the whole idea over here is he's hoping to flank across the flank across the army we've got and then kind of run down our lines. Well, let's see if it works out for him. Here's what we have across from him. We were at a bit of a disadvantage here, and it's because we have that kind of short edge of the table. He gets the whole table edge to deploy, and we get less. So my task here was to bottleneck his army right past, if you'll see that piece of... that watchtower, we counted that as an impassable piece of terrain. So I was hoping to bottleneck everything on the right side, whereas Midnight Fox was going to sweep across that left side and crush what was over there with the disciples and the Blight Monks. I had really a decision here about what I wanted to do with the Yetis. They could go either to the right or they could go to the left. Either one would have worked for me. I've got one Scratatatapult back here with the mounted with their little fraglins. There's actually a giant in a vermin demon right behind the tree. I put it there. I actually put the tree down after we deployed, hoping my opponents would forget that they were there and not shoot at them. So it's a small bit of trickery on my part. So here's the first, I guess it's the right flank of the table. I really just wanted to march straight forward. I played a few of these big games before, and I find that if your chaff can't really keep up with you, you just don't get through enough turns to really bait and flee stuff. So you need to just kind of bust ahead and just hope everything turns out for the best. So I'm going to try to be not as cautious as I am in most of my games. But we'll see if that pans out for me. Now, here's what I'll be facing. There's Bone 67's army. I'm very familiar with Undying Dynasties. I've played it many, many times. I feel pretty confident that I can run straight across, smash it, and hopefully swing around that tower and flank Lil Ed over there. It's a little ambitious because I'd have to do it in 4 turns. I don't expect us to get to turn 5 or 6 because, like I said, these games take a very long time. We started this at about 2 in the afternoon, we finished at 9, so we had been playing for 7 hours. There's Lil Ed's. It's a chariot-based army. You can see it's very different from what Bone 67 had on the right. He just tries to hit you as fast as possible and as hard as possible. They also have lots of artillery on the other side of the table. A couple of caskets and a couple of catapults. We really just have Midnight Foxes to warp cannons, and that's really about it. We don't have a whole lot of artillery on our side, which is unfortunate, because the shooting game definitely matters. And here's the other side, right after Lil Ed, and this is Skittles' Sylvan Elves. It's a wood elf army. It's got lots of shooting. It's in a bit of a disadvantage because the combat prowess isn't, it's meant to play a full six turn game, whereas this is not really meant to do that. She does have the a couple units of Wild Riders. There's actually one right next to the Pidgeot over on the right side. I think that Sisterhood, she's using those Sisterhood models as Wild Riders. I can't quite remember. Based on what I see them do later on, they're probably Wild Riders. But it really looks like she's going to try to hold down this flank and just let the others sweep through. So here's what Midnight Fox has directly across from Lil' Ed. You can see we've got the Underlings and the Clan Vermin out in front. They're really holding up things like that Super Vermin Demon over there in the Vermin Guard. By the way, the Vermin Demon, I believe we're using the Exalted Skaven, whatever, Rat Demon rules from the Mantras Arcanum. But like I said, the real heart of this army are kind of in the second ranks. And if you don't get through, if the first ranks kind of hold things up for a couple turns, those guys won't get into combat until late. And you really need to do your damage early in these big games. So hopefully we can pull these guys out of the way and be able to get into some flanks and actually do some hard hitting. But we'll see. And here's on the right side of the table, directly across from Skittles' Sylvan Elves. We have lots of rats. I think she's outnumbered some 20-1 on this side of the table. There's just so much going on. Those Vermin Ogres will be tough for her. I know the Vermin Guard with the Doom Bell is a unit that she's that's very hard for her to deal with. But we've also got that Dreadmill and the Warp Cannon on the right side. I'm not sure how the Dreadmill and the Horrors are going to do in this game, mainly because of the random movement. They could go really far, they might not go far enough, and you're just not quite sure. In a game like this, where there's not a lot of space to hide, because you can't go to the left or to the right, they'll just get hit. So we'll see if they can get into the right spot. All right, here is turn one. Wow, that's a nice looking table. Anyway, so here's how it starts. We rolled off to see who was going to go first, and our opponents actually got the first turn. And then there was some debate about what they wanted to do, because Turkey Sub wanted to pray and pick up his blessing. And, you know, typically in and under the Equitaine rules, you have to go to the second turn. So we decided to put it to a vote. And it turned out to be a 5-1 vote to let the opposing side go, but Turkey Sub would not be able to go. There was one opposing vote. I think you could probably figure out who that was. So he got to go out to lunch, and the rest of his team got to move first. So here we go. This is Bone 67 moving up. He's very wary about his giants, or his colossuses, getting sniped. And the reason why he's worried is because he sees that unit of man-eaters. The feat that I pulled off against Little Ed right now is spreading around this room, where I killed off his prince in one turn of shooting. And he just wants to make sure I can't knock out the Soul Colossus so early, but at the same time be able to use it to flank and everything. He's being very cautious here, as you can see. There's Little Ed's army. Now, Little Ed actually didn't want to move forward, or he didn't want to be across from me. Where I decided to put my stuff down, he immediately shifted places, because originally he was directly across from me. And that was pretty funny. It was some comedy in the room. And he's just going to move right forward. He knows there are rats in front of him, and he just doesn't care. And here's Skittles on the other side. She's doing what, you know, Sylvan Elves do, which is cautiously move up and just screen and cover. Here's where she's really going to move forward, is with the Wild Riders and everything. So here's shooting the first turn, immediately knocks off four wounds on the Horror, which is never good. I think Midnight failed every one of his regen saves on this guy. There's me taking three wounds. This is just from Tomb King shooting. It was incredibly lucky. If you saw the game against Little Ed, you saw that his shooting did absolutely nothing. Is the exact opposite here, where Bone just shot at me and I just took wounds. And there's that Horror dying. Like I said, he failed everything. The last shot I think came from a catapult. So that one he wouldn't even gotten the regen save from. And there's the Warp Lightning Cannon, or Warp Cannon, on the other side. It took 3 wounds. It's got 4 wounds, so it's got 1 left, but it's not long for this world. I mean, the next round of shooting is going to take it out. So this is us. And this is, we have a couple of opening charges. One against those bugs this would have been Little Ed left right in front of me. He really just didn't want me vanguarding, because this is still using the 7.0 rules where the Yetis could vanguard. So he just didn't want me moving forward. So I just decided to charge and smash some bugs. On this side, Midnight threw some of these must be underlings, because they don't have any weapon teams attached to them, right at the skeletal calf. He's just going to destroy him. I mean, it's not going to be anything there. So this is what the right side of the board looks like. Like I said before, we really want to split this into this table really in half, with Midnight being able to just plow forward with the Blight Monks and the Disciples. I really like the Disciples. They are pretty hard-hitting. We also have those two catapults. I can't remember what their names are. Blight catapults, probably. That just kill knights really, really well. We also have the Scrat-Tat-Tatapult over there. So it's going to be able to knock out some armor as well. So here's what we end up doing. Big Fats moving up to kind of support the Rat Ogres. I'm really worried about those Rat Ogres. Because they're immune to Psych, he can't flee with them. And I don't mind fleeing my units all over the place. And that's just being able to countercharge is more important to me. But if he gets those Rat Ogres too far forward, he's just going to take a charge from those knights, and they're just going to overrun into our backfields, and we don't have the numbers on this right side of the table. The left side, we have lots of numbers. We've got a couple of ranks and, you know, repetitiveness all over the place. But on this right side, if he takes out any units, he's just going to be in the backfield, and we can't afford to have him flanking across my Ogres. So here's the center of the table just advancing. Midnight's moving all of his rats up. Yeah, he'll be able to hold up some of these things, like the cav units. But I'm not sure what the clan vermin are going to be able to do beyond that. He does have a lot of those weapon teams, and those things can be very, very deadly. So here's the middle of the table, everything moving up. We actually have a few special characters we were using from the old Skaven books in here as well. As you can see, there's Bone Ripper in the middle of the table. And there's our Blight Furnace moving up. Take out this poor, poor Sylvan Elves over there. It's going to be pretty rough. I think that he can really just run over this flank. There's just not a lot in front of him. And those Treemen, they can take wounds, or Treants can take wounds from all of these massed number of attacks. So there's my shooting in the first turn. It was not nearly as effective as it was when I played against Little Ed. I wish I could have taken the giant down in one, the Colossus down in one turn. Those things are killing machines. I have a very healthy fear of them, and I don't want them to get into combat. Yep, and that unit used to have a few more guys in it, and the Scrat-Tat-Tatapult and the Blight Cannons, or Blight Catapults, did a few wounds to it. I thought they should have done more wounds, but that was all we got. Our shooting was not particularly effective. Our opponent's shooting was way more effective. And we killed the Pidgeotto. I don't know what killed the Pidgeotto, but something killed the Pidgeotto. It was probably one of the warp cannons. I remember that he was having problems finding something he could shoot at. So here's me. I killed some bugs. I bet everybody thought that was going to happen. Oh, look. And those cav are dead as well. Well, dead again. But once again, no surprises. Ah, turn two. So here come some charges. The elves are charging into the vermin over there. Hopefully he doesn't make this. I don't want him to get too close to our lines with those guys. And here's just more skeletal cav charging in. These guys aren't going to do anything. They might get into combat, do a couple of wounds, and then just die. And those are also I don't remember their names, but the old GW names were Wild Riders. A huntsman, I guess. And here's another picture of them. So here's how this side turns out. He obviously did not make that charge right there, which is great. Like I said, I don't want him getting that close to our lines with a unit that's as scary as that. That is the most combat effective unit right there. Or that skill is most combat effective unit. So that Bone Giant's trying to charge into those Clan Vermin, and it's the same thing with the chariots over there. He's going to make both these charges. They're very close. I think he needs like a 5 for the Bone Giant, and with the chariots, probably like an 8. Maybe not even that. Maybe a 7 or something. And over here, the only one that I really care about is that Skeletal Cav is trying to charge the Warp Cannon, and I want our artillery to actually be able to do something in this game. And if he gets into that Warp Cannon, that would just be bad, because he'd be able to go right to the left or the right. Little Ed just be able to take out everything in our backfield. So this really, really can't happen. It was we left this hole open by accident, and that's just what happens. So here you can see what actually got in. Like I said, the Little Ed's Colossus got in. It's just going to wreck those Clan Rats. Same with the Chariots. That's a lot of impact hits, and they've got a lot of attacks. And they're really just Clan Vermin hanging around right there. Nothing special about them. And you can see the Cav at the bottom. Those guys, the Cav are going to lose that one. I mean, they don't have that many attacks, and they're not super hitty or anything. More really, those guys just divert and then die. Yep, we got some ambushers showing up. Their ambushers came on immediately. Ours hesitated, I guess. As you can see, my gorgers are kind of hanging out in that farmhouse. They're not really there. They're just trying to remind me to roll for them. By the way, all of the terrain that's in this game was provided to us by Piglet. He didn't actually play in this game. He was busy doing his stuff around the house, but we played at his place. He gave us the tables, he gave us the terrain, he gave us the time to be able to stay here. It was really great of him. None of this could have been accomplished without him. All right, there's more stuff popping up, and we really don't have anything to take these guys out unless we just turn around entirely, which is not optimum, I guess. But this is over by, right across from the Sylvan Elves. So Skittles' entire army is right on the other side. You can see the Wild Riders at the top right. Huntsman. So here's some more stuff. It's just moving around. There's not a lot going on over here. Here's him being cautious. I'm not sure what Turkey Sub's doing. I think he just has a healthy fear of me on the other side of the table. I talk a mean game on the other side, and I am trying to outbluff more than a few of my opponents with how strong my army is and what it's going to do and so on and so forth. It's false bravado. I have very little going for me on the other side of the table. I mean, you've seen what's over there. The Rat Ogres really are a one-hit wonder, and the Big Fat can't hold his own in combat, although the Always Strikes Last is really nice. People have seen how the Always Strikes Last combined with really anything has worked very well in my favor, so they just have a healthy fear of it. Anyway, this is what the entire table looks like. Looks like an army fighting force. So here's the other side of the table. Boned is just moving forward. I need to draw some of his line out because I don't want to go in unsupported and just hang out. I have a healthy fear of the pyramid guard. Those guys can do a lot of damage, and I don't want my units engaged in it unless I can multi-charge it. There's just a lot of stuff over there that I don't want to get in combat. And the thing is when you get into when you get into combat with the Undying Dynasties, you're generally stuck there for a couple of turns. So it gives him the opportunity to flank you. And ogres are not known for their ability to survive being flanked. Sustained combats are just not for them. So I want to avoid that situation. If I can pull some of his units forward, that would be the way to go. I'm not sure why I didn't put any dogs in this army. I'm not even sure why I didn't have eight Yetis in this army. But I just didn't put them in. And that would have been really, really nice because I could have thrown these guys out there and bought myself a turn. So it's just another pick, just to show that the Colossus on the other side with the Soul Colossus right across. If you're wondering, magic is not a huge thing in this game. When you get to tons and tons of points, magic's just not that big a deal. You buff a couple units here and there, you throw out a magic missile, and it's almost not worth noting. So here's the middle of the table. As you can see, Lil Ed has just gone full speed across the table. He is fully engaged with his army. He wants to get in, and he wants to just rip the heart out of the center of our lines. I think he has a general idea of what my plan is, and he wants to make sure he's not there. That's a good idea. So here's the left side of the table, just showing you how the Sylvan Elves are just moving around. And there's Skittles. Hi, Skittles. So, at the end of shooting and magic, actually, no, this is the end of magic. We let, I think it was Fury of the Forest or something along those lines, something that did hit because it was within a few inches of a forest. It did a number on these guys, and we thought that they'd be a lot more resilient because they're toughness 4, and I think it was only strength 5, but he rolled really high and then really well, and he knocked out almost all of them. So a unit we thought could really work well once it got into combat, especially against the knights, is now totally decimated. We really thought these guys were going to hold up much better than they did. There goes my giant. Not that I thought that he was going to do a lot this game, but yeah, that's giants. I love them. I got lots of them. I still got the other one on the flank, but this guy's gone. Poor Thad. There's shooting. Took out the last two. This is Peasant Bowman. This is one unit of Peasant Bowman. He just happened to hit twice and did two wounds to him, and that was the end of them. So no more disciples for us. So here's the middle of the table again, all these combats. You can see that the Cav did not do well. I don't think they did anything, and they just got killed. Well, the Chariots just pounded away at that unit of Clan Vermin. I don't know. Oh, there's, you can see how he stayed there. He didn't roll very high. He rolled a 3. I guess that's exactly what he needed. But next turn, those guys are just going to go away. It probably would have been better if they just broke in or something, maybe. And then he could have gotten the Clan Vermin, the Vermin Guard in there, and they could have ripped apart those Chariots. But as it stands, that's just going to be a grind right there. Because even if he gets those Vermin at the bottom into that unit of Chariots, I don't think he's got the combat res to take it out. Because Clan Vermin aren't known for doing active combat res. They might do 3 or 4 wounds in static combat res a turn, but just not enough to get rid of those Chariots in one go. Really needs a bunch of small support units in here. I guess that's something that the disciples could do, because I know you can take them in small numbers. That'd probably be the way to go. Maybe small units of Radogers or something. So here's the Colossus, the War Colossus that I spoke so highly about over and over again. It just whiffed everything, and he took a wound for his troubles. It did not go very well. I think he just rolled ones for everything. Just one of those. Yep, over here, the Wild Riders just pummeled the crap out of those Clan Vermin. And overran into the flank of the Vermin Ogres. The problem with this is that it's going to hold up that Blight Furnace, because he's not going to be able to get around it. That's just a huge problem with having these units. As soon as they get held up, they're stuck there, and they'll hold up the second wave. And this, I'm not sure they'll be able to get rid of these guys immediately. I guess he's got the Clan Vermin at the bottom, so he can flank charge this and knock it away. But for five huntsmen, I mean, she didn't have to do very much, and she's going to take quite a toll on the army. So here is the left side. This is the start of our turn. You can see we charge the giant rodents into those woods right there in the front. I believe it's fighting Skittles' dryads. Yep, those are dryads. On the left side, the Dreadmill just went not far enough, if I remember correctly. It needed to go a few more inches to plow into those huntsmen, and that would have been great, but it didn't get there. As a result, it's just sitting out there, and it's just going to get killed by something because, well, it's got the tree. You can fight against the tree folk over there, and that'll be something it can fight against, but I'm not expecting it to win those. It's more of a chariot than it is anything else. It does a little grinding, but not a ton. So here's the center. As you can see, the Clan Vermin are flanking that unit of Wild Rider of Huntsmen, and there is a weapons team that I didn't notice before. It's the one that does the impact hits. So they're just going to wipe these guys out. But still, the Huntsmen did their job, and they're just going to hold up that unit of Blight of not Blight. That's got to be a. I think those are just Vermin Guard with the bell. As a result, Midnight just turned him around, and so he's just going to deal with the Stalkers instead. It's a shame, because, like I said, that unit could have gone forward, but really couldn't. It couldn't get around the Red Ogres, and that's just a lost turn. So here's what that huge cluster in the middle looks. Little Ed's just going in. You can see the support units have charged in here to try to clean out the stuff that Little Ed threw up front. The Clan Vermin charged in the chariots, just like I said they would. I don't think the Exalted Rat Demon got into combat there. It's just kind of hanging out. It moved over there to be able to do it if the Cav are still there next turn. I don't think they will be. Unfortunately, we don't have anything to deal with that Mr. Pinchy down there, so he's just going to eat himself a warp cannon on the next turn. Here's me doing the exact opposite of what I said I was going to do at the beginning, which is being cautious. I did move those Yetis up. I moved them up too far. I shouldn't have moved them up that far. They're movement 7, they're swift stride. The Shoptees are only movement 6, no swift stride. I was really hoping that I could bait the Shoptees into charging or not charging, just based on bluffing, because he wasn't going to be able to beat the Yetis in 1-on-1. The Yetis are just going to pound the Shoptees into dust with Big Fat right there, because as soon as the Shoptees come in, the Yetis are just going to go first and just wipe them out. What I didn't count on was how close they were to the snakes right there in the middle. Snakes are much faster, and I know the Yetis can't handle both units, and they're immune to psych in this patch. So that's a huge problem for me, because I can't flee. Here's the right side of the table. Those Rat Ogres are moving forward in hopes to bait one unit of Knights up. And that's really the whole plan here, is to try to get them forward and then support with the Rat Demon, the Scratchite Tadapult, and the Giant. And if Big Fat has to come in, Big Fat will come in. Here's the right side. Like I said, we are dividing this area. So you see the Blight Monks. You don't see any Disciples, unfortunately, which were kind of important. So I'm just going to hang out, not be there. And we turned around one unit of Clan Vermin over there to deal with some pesky ambushers. Oh, and Turkey Sub's flicking me off. Thanks there, Turkey. So here's the middle. There used to be a giant. There used to be a Colossus over here, but I shot him to bits. So he's dead now. We do have that one champion right there that's holding up the Soul Colossus, and that's just a couple of rats. So the Scratchite Tadapult did bullseye a unit and killed a single knight. I was so proud of this, I had to make sure to show it off. Go, Scratchite Tadapult! Fraglins, I'll tell you, they just don't do a lot of damage. They're so cute, though. Here's the other side. You can see that combat. Yeah, the rats just murdered those guys. Here's that middle. Like I said, the War Colossus. And it did best case scenario, which is flood that first round, succeed in the second round, and then get that reform. So he can face in any direction he wants. If he wants to go with the Vermin Guard, he can go with the Vermin Guard. If he wants to go support the chariots, he can support the chariots. It's not a good situation for us because there's nothing we can do to stop it. But like I said, he just had that really bad first round. In the second round, he just did what the Colossus does best, just kill stuff. There's chariots. They're just being grinded down right now, but not very fast. Yep, and there's the Cav who just disappeared. Like I said, I don't even think the Exalted was involved. I think it was just the Clan Vermin, and he just didn't do any damage. And it's turn 3. So, just like I said before, the Treants are going to go into that treadmill right there, and the Huntsmen are just going to plow into those poor rats and just get absolutely murdered. All those rats are going to die. It's just going to go bad. You can see the Dryads charged into the Clan Vermin right there as well. So this is what the middle of the table is looking like at this point. I mean, it's still pretty clear. The Sylvan Elves just don't want to commit. Skittles knows what she's doing. She's not going to commit anything she doesn't have to. She feels that she's got the range advantage, and it's a pain for them to go digging through everything. So here's the middle of the table, that huge mess right there. The War Colossus charged into the bigger of the two rat units, and then another unit of skeletons committed as well. So that's just going to blow up all those rats right there. Over here, yeah. Another unit of chariots charged into the Clan Vermin. It's going to do a big number on those Clan Vermin, and it's going to wipe them out. The weapons team did a little bit of damage in the stand and shoot, but not enough to save that unit. So this is what I wasn't big on. This is exactly what I didn't want to happen, where he got both units into those Yetis, and there was nothing I could do about it. The current patch, Yetis are not immune to Psych, but they don't Vanguard. So I really missed the Vanguarding ability, because I still feel that they're kind of not, they don't really serve a huge purpose. But they can scout, so that's not bad. But the Yetis, even with Big Fat right there, aren't going to be able to survive this. They're just going to die. So here's the right side. Exactly what I said, it didn't want to happen. Rat Ogres got pulled too far forward and got charged by three units. They're not going to be able to survive that. What's going to happen is he's just going to plow into everything else. So here's what the other side of the board looks like. Turkey Subs just kind of moving forward very slowly. He's not doing very much, doesn't need to. There's not a ton on this side of the table other than that furnace. So, yeah, this is what happened after combats. Or actually, no, sorry, this is shooting. I'm not sure what got shot in this one. I think it knocked out, Skittles shot away one of the weapon teams, the one that does the impact hits. She's just targeting all the little stuff. She's leaving the big units alone. So over here, the Dreadmill actually won combat. I've been naysaying it this whole time, and I said it wasn't going to do anything, but it actually won combat. The tree folk just flubbed all their attacks. Midnight did a couple of wounds back, and they just took off running. Unfortunately, the same can't be said for those poor vermin in the front. I'm not sure how many actually survived that combat. They were butchered horribly. So here's the middle of the table. The War Colossus just exploded everything. And now the Vermin Guard are stuck with not that many good, well, really, no good things to charge. They can't charge the Chariots, can't charge the War Colossus, obviously. I don't think they can see the Skeletons over there. The only thing they could charge is the Pyramid Guard with a Pharaoh in it, which is not ideal. Even though those are special rats, they still don't do tons of damage. And it's just going to get flanked the next turn because of those Skeletons. It's just not a good. It's not a good place right there. I guess they've got Bone Ripper. They can throw Bone Ripper in front, but you know, it was all because that War Colossus got that reform at the end of the previous turn. So here's the other side. The Chariots did not utterly destroy the unit of Clan Rats. It did a lot of damage, but they managed to stay. I was not nearly as lucky here. So the Yetis got away. That's a bonus. Bad size. The Snakes rear charge Big Fat over there. But they did not get out of charge range, or the charge arc of my unit of Ironclad with my BSB and a Great Weapon. So I'm hoping that I can just knock out that unit. I won't be able to get all my guys. I should be able to just get two guys in close combat with the Cataphracts. But that should be enough. So here's what it looks like in the center of the table after Bone67's done all of his movement. All the combats and stuff, I guess. Yep, this is the other side of the table. Those Rat Ogres just went poof. They fled, which was good, so it changed the direction where some of the knights were going to go. If you remember, it's always center instead of straight forward. If it was straight forward, he would have run right into the giant with one of those units, and that would have been bad news for the giant. But as it was, he went that way. It kind of held up a few things, and the rat demon is stuck in combat with some chariots. It should destroy those chariots. It's got, you know, six attacks, do D3 wounds. I mean, the chariots are only strength 4 impact hits. He should just be able to butcher the things. So here's more combat. This is what looks like the whole table side after those other combats. Oh, so here's some movement going on. Yeah, there's the charge into the snakes down there, or the stalkers. Those things are just going to get destroyed. I mean, they're not that good in combat, just a couple of strength 5 attacks apiece anyway. There's the sitter on the table. The rats are really moving forward. They're trying to push the Sylvans. So you can see those I guess those are probably underlings. They might be clan vermin. have charged into the Dryads, hopes of clearing them out and maybe getting into some of the squishier elf stuff. But then the Blade Singers over there are pretty deadly, and it's not like any of that stuff's pushover. So, yep, here's the center of the table where the absolute rout that's happening from Lil Ed in that center is trying to turn around. You can see the Vermin Guard have charged into the Pyramid Guard, and hopefully they can take care of them, but it's going to be a tough one right there. And here's me. I decided to do a little committing. I actually think I failed the charge with the bulls into that unit of Pyramid Guard. I'm not entirely sure why I would have done that, but I think that's what happened. I think I had some sort of plan. It was probably a bad plan. So I'm glad it didn't work. But still, I'm going to take out that Soul Colossus in one round. The way I pulled that thing forward is he charged that little unit of rodents, and he didn't expect me to flee. I simply fled, and he caught them, and he was stuck where he was. And he failed to reform. So he couldn't go anywhere. If he hit me and just stopped, he could have just stayed. Or hit me and killed him, he could have just stayed where he was, pretty much. That's how I managed to draw that forward. So here's that mess of a right side. That's just going bad over here. The giant charged into one of those knight units in hopes that it can hold him up. This is before they got the rerolls. So I think there are a couple paladins in that unit as well. So hopefully the giant can kill the unit. He should be able to. He's got the charge and a flank and everything. There's not that many attacks, but he's a giant, which means he's not very good. So here's the right side of the table, just pushing forward. And there we go. I crushed the Soul Colossus, and I crushed that unit of skeletons. I actually didn't do that many wounds. And, you know, remember, whatever you do is kind of doubled because of combat resolution. I didn't do as much as I expected to. I thought that was going to be smaller. I did crush that Soul Colossus. It was bad. That's poison attacks and everything, so those Man-Eaters are no pushover. And my combats were never great this whole game. I just didn't do as much damage as I expected to do from the Ironclad charging in there with not only their attacks, but with the BSB's attacks as well, and all of the impact hits. I thought that I'd be able to knock out most of these snakes in one round of combat, and I didn't get anywhere near. And there's a Gorger popping up on the table. I think only one showed up. I don't think the other two ever show up. Yeah, so, like I said, combat's not so... Oh, wait, one Gorger did show up. Combat's not all so good. As you see, the giant, I think, killed... That must be two guys, and the rat demon killed virtually nothing with his D3 wounding, you know, blade of I destroy everything that's multi-wound. He just missed all his attacks. Just, you know, he's got a whole bunch, and he just said, well, I don't feel like hitting. But that was the story of a lot of our combats. So, yeah. Happens. Over here, yeah, this is such a mess. We've got the rats right there to hopefully charge into the stalkers in the flank, but I don't think anybody really cares what happens over here. So, yep, there's more combat. That just mess. You see the Tomb Guard took a bunch of damage, but not enough. Bone Ripper's in there as well, but we need to do a whole bunch more damage to really knock that Pyramid Guard unit out. Oh, also, you can see the chariots are gone from the Exalted Demon doing whatever it is the Exalted Demon does. Yep, turn four. So, now we have possibly the most epic combat that will take place in any of these games. We have little rats versus termites, and scarabs, and little bits of junk. So, yeah... It was pretty funny when they put that down, and we stopped to laugh at it for a little while. That's just going to be the stalkers are going to fight the vermin up there, and these guys are just going to duke it out. So more stuff here. They've been steadily shooting that unit of Blight Monks. As you can see, there's not a lot of them left. That tray started off filled with Blight Monks, and now we're down to almost just one rank. I mean, that back rank is starting to whittle down pretty quickly. So over here, he just moved forward. I think he failed the charge, and that's what would pull him forward. Oh, also the Shopties hit the flank of my of Big Fat over there, which is unfortunate. As you can see, the center. The Hierophant's moving up, trying to get away from the Gorger all the way back there. There's just a whole bunch of stuff that's dead. Most of Bone 67's forces are committed right now, so there's not a lot for him to do. Yeah, it's after combat. I wiped out one unit of skeletons. My man-eaters completely flubbed their attacks. I barely killed anything, despite the fact that they were striking at, I think, the same... It was either the same or greater... I think it's greater initiative than the pyramid guard. So I struck first, and then didn't do anything as a result. And it really sucked, but, eh. It's a game of dice. Happens. I thought I could do a bunch more damage before I died, because I was going to die. I just thought I'd be able to knock out a couple of ranks. So over here, Big Fat unfortunately died. Those Shopties, they've got, you know, a lot of very high weapon strength attacks, so Big Fat was going to go down there. I thought that I was going to be able to kill off the Cataphracts. I once again failed miserably at killing off the Cataphracts. He couldn't generate that much combat res from the Shopty killing Big Fat because he'd taken a couple of wounds already. But I just, just couldn't do it with strength 6 and strength 7 attacks. Like I said, combats were not favorable to us. Over here, yep, that's just going to keep going on. It'll go on for another turn or two before the Clan Vermin eventually break. There's those knights moving up. I think they took a bunch of dangerous terrain. Also, the Rat Demon finally killed off the chariots. He took 2 wounds for his trouble from the chariots. And all those rounds of combat, just too many rounds of combat. So over here, you've got those Rat Ogres getting assaulted by all the trees now. Like I said, couldn't flee to get away from them, so they're just kind of stuck there, holding up the center of that table. As you can see on the top right, the rats are now gone. The Dryads have driven them off. But right here, I think eventually those Rat Ogres might win the combat. Oh no, this used to be, there were 2 trees and the Tree of Folk. And what happened was, is somehow the rats, the Vermin Ogres won combat, and one tree broke and took off running. Not sure how that happened, but like I said, it's a game of dice. It's funny when things like that happen. So here's the middle. Charged in those huntsmen, and they did a number on the bell unit. So yeah, we actually do play another half a turn, but it's late, and we're trying to get through it very, very quickly. We really just play out a few combats here and there. I believe we do wipe out those huntsmen that you saw right on the table. On the right side, I do manage to get rid of those pesky cataphracts, and I do manage to kill off his Hierophant too, and wipe out pretty much everything that that Bones got on the table outside those pyramid guard. And that was really the only thing he had left. So I managed to do what I needed to do, but he kept me from turning the corner and locking in Lil Ed, where at the same time, Lil Ed just barreled across the table, so he wasn't even there if I had managed to get around. On the right side against Turkey Sub, yeah, we tried to hold stuff up, and that was about it. We didn't do very much. If I remember, the Blight Monks failed their charge in the final turn. They didn't even get into combat the entire game. The Giant died because I don't know what. He just kept getting hit and wounded every time. I charged the Scrat Tat Tatapult into something. It wasn't that we cared. It was really one of these, well, it's the final half turn. We might as well roll some dice and see what stuff happens. It's pretty funny. And the Rat Demon charged into one of the Knight units and also died for his troubles. It's pretty bad luck on our part. I'd say overall it was a reasonably poor showing for us. So you've listened to me ramble on for some 40 minutes or so, and now you know clearly who won this game. It wasn't particularly close. We were only looking at it from a left, right, and center sort of deal. So whoever we just thought won each flank and the center would get a point for it. And if you looked on that table, the center was still fairly contested because I'd routed Bone 67. Lil Ed had routed Midnight in the middle. And on the left and the right sides, Turkey Sub had really crushed that right flank, whereas the Sylvan Elves probably in another turn would have routed that left flank too. So the flanks we definitely lost. So we all conceded the victory to not us, to Skittles, Turkey Sub, Lil Ed, and Bone 67. It was a great, great game. If I had to choose an MVP for this game, it's probably going to be Lil Ed, because he went right after Midnight in that center. He has those units of Cav, which he doesn't expect to live or really do any damage, but he was just charging them in to hold up the Skaven lines and disrupt the flow of the army. And just keep the combat units in the back ranks and just hold the lines where he needed to, so he'd get those chariots into their optimum positions. And it was very smart. And he did it because he didn't want to be there when I got there. So that was a good plan. And we talked about it after the game, and he had a good idea of what he wanted to do, and he managed to accomplish it. The rest of us really, you know, we pissed around a little bit. So at the end of this, we all had a blast. I have to thank everybody. I really have to thank Piglet for helping us out with this one. He said that we can go there anytime, so we have an opportunity to go back there and do this again. And we probably will in a couple of months. So we'll just have to figure that out. So I just want to thank all of you for coming out and, you know, watching my battle report. Subscribe and like the video if you want to, and that really helps me out. I guess it helps me out. And, well, all of you, good night and take it easy.